healthcare environment, we see people going through very stressful situations, which means we see many people emotional, angry, or upset, often at their worst rather than at their best. Customers may get angry and upset for many reasons, some of which are out of our control. Other times, however, the source of frustration is a service breakdown experience. When something occurs that upsets a customer, he or she will expect a lot of effort to make things better. If they are not satisfied, they will shop around and tell many others about their bad experience. On the other hand, overcoming bad experiences keeps the customer's business and spreads positive word of mouth. In the first program of this series, we learned how to determine and satisfy the healthcare customer's needs in order to create loyal clients. However, it is not always possible to prevent all problems, and in healthcare's stressful environment, service breakdowns can easily occur. In this program, we explore what to do should a customer become upset and how to respond appropriately in order to meet and then exceed their expectations. Before we begin, let's explore some common reasons why healthcare customers may become angry or upset. First, the customer may feel their needs have not been met in some way. Their anger may be justified by an error or other situation brought on by someone at the facility. A staff member could have been rude, indifferent, or impatient. The customer or a family member is worried about their own or a loved one's negative diagnosis or prognosis. The customer is frustrated by waiting for treatment or answers for themselves or family members. Some people are just easily irritable and don't restrain anger in general. And finally, the customer's anger may be caused by a misunderstanding brought on by cultural insensitivity. For example, due to language, stereotyping, or prejudice. Whatever the source, there are various ways for dealing with customers who are angry or upset so that both you and the customer feel better about the interaction. The goal is to turn the customer's anger and disappointment into satisfaction, first by correcting the problem, then by making amends in such a way that satisfies the customer and makes them happy to return. The main strategies for dealing with angry customers are focused attention, de-escalation, consciously controlling your thoughts and responses, avoiding phrases that may further upset the client, allowing the customer time and space to vent, and applying active listening and empathy. These strategies will effectively handle most angry situations. Focused attention tells customers that their providers are helpful and interested. If a customer is angry, take the time to focus your attention solely on the customer at that moment and figure out what you need to do to meet his or her needs. This begins with de-escalation. De-escalation is the practice of diffusing an emotionally charged situation with non-aggressive responses. When you are confronted by an angry customer, maintain at least one, preferably two, arm lengths between you and the individual. This ensures you are not invading the customer's personal space and leaves room for your personal safety as well. If the encounter is in a public space, invite the individual to a separate, quieter area to talk if possible. This will reduce any stimulation the individual may be getting from the setting and take away their audience. Then, exhibit a calm and caring attitude and remain professional by speaking softly in a non-judgmental, non-provocative manner. You will help the individual mirror the same behavior, and this will go a long way to diffusing the situation.